And I remind supporters of the resolution that the newly confirmed commander in Iraq says this is a new strategy and it will work, and he is the expert on counterinsurgency. And with that, I yield 5 minutes to the gentleman from Wisconsin, the ranking member of the Budget Committee, for 5 minutes. Mr. Ryan.
Gentleman from Wisconsin is recognized for 5 minutes.
I thank the gentleman for yielding. Friends and colleagues, I'm glad we're having this debate. It's good to debate the most important issue facing our country, the most important issue facing the world. I'm glad we're talking about Iraq. We need to have a debate about Iraq. I have grave concerns about the conduct of this war. You know, I look back at the last 3 or 4 years, and I think to myself, boy, I would have done that differently. I would have done this differently. They should have done that. They should have done this. I think we all can look at hindsight and see how things should have been done differently. Well, here's where we are. The question is this the right resolution to pass? You know, I, for one, don't know if this strategy is going to work or not. I believe our troops are going to do exactly what we asked them to do. I have perfect confidence that the U.S. soldiers, airmen, Army, and Marines are going to do exactly what we asked them to do, and they will do their jobs. Where my doubts lay are with the Iraqi government. Will the Iraqi government do that is what we are asking them to do? Will the Iraqi government do what is needed to do to hold up their end of the bargain? I don't know. But what I do know is this. If we pass this resolution, which while our troops are in the middle of implementing this mission, while our troops are over there right now implementing this strategy, and we pass this resolution, which says, you know what? We don't think you can succeed. We don't think you can do the job. We don't think you can do what you are being asked to do right now. That is a slap in the face. It is a killer of morale. This is the wrong message to send our troops. We have to think about the alternatives. We have to think about the consequences of failure. We have to think about the message this sends our troops. We have to think about the message this sends our enemies. Madam Speaker, by telling the world, by telling Americans, and by telling our enemies and our troops, we don't think this is going to work, we don't think this can succeed, what message does that send? And for those who say, this won't work and I'm voting for this resolution, it is your obligation to tell us how better you can do this. What is your plan? What is your strategy? Because we have to think about the consequences of failure. We have to accept and know that if we just pull out, we will have sectarian genocide. We will have a safe haven for terrorists with oil money. We will have a Middle East power struggle that will be very, very ugly, where countries that are very hostile to us, like Iran and Syria, will have the run of the region. We have to look at those consequences. But more important than anything else, Madam Speaker, is the fact that I just cannot look our soldiers in the eyes, and I'm traveling to this region in a few days, I cannot look them in the eyes and tell them that when I was in the comforts of Congress, I sat there high in my pedestal, and I told the American people and you that the mission you're about to engage in, the job you're trying hard to do for us, you can't complete it. You're incapable. It won't work. Why bother trying? I can't send that message to our troops. With that, Madam Speaker, I urge a no vote. This is the right debate to have, the wrong resolution to pass. I yield.